You are watching Feast Week, presented by Lowe's. This is the Bad Boy Mowers Battle for Atlantis, as we welcome you to the Bahamas and the beautiful Atlantis Resort on Paradise Island. We are ready for game one of 12 of the next 3 days. And we got here today. There's plenty of ways to get here. We got here today via water slide. That's the best way. Start with two tourney teams from last season. Loyola University Chicago set to face the Michigan State Spartans. Six of the eight teams in this tournament played in the NCAA's last season, including defending national champion Baylor, which gets started later against Arizona State. It is great to be with you. I'm Eric Fried. I'm expected to be joined by Carolyn Peck, but there's no sign of Carolyn Peck because I've been told when you've coached a team to a national championship like Carolyn Peck has, you get to broadcast from any location you please. So, Carolyn, what's going on?
Hey, Eric, I'm down here at the marina on a yacht. The inspiration. I'm on board. Oh, yeah. I guess I probably should get back to the game. Loyola, best, one of the best shooting teams, best offenses in the country, is going against Michigan State. That is a stingy, gritty defense. We're in for a good one. I'm on my way. I'm coming.
Don't take your time, but it looks nice out there, Carolyn. So we'll see you when we see you as we take a look at Michigan State. The Spartans at 3-1. Loyola Ramblers with Drew Valentine, their head coach, 4-0, all four of their games played at home. And here they are in a neutral court to take on Michigan State. This is a good one to get us started here at the Atlantis. Loyola coming off a victory over UIC Saturday. And Michigan State with a win over Eastern Michigan on Saturday. State in white, Loyola and Michigan State underway here in the Bahamas.
Eric, I'm here. I'm back. I made it. I made it.
That was fast. I didn't think we'd see you for a while. I'm glad that you didn't go on a three-hour tour, because usually those don't work out very well. But it's great to have you here, CP. What should we watch for here today as Michigan State gets going with their first possession?
Well, the Loyola Ramblers have gotten off to a great start this season, shooting the basketball, moving the basketball. They're second in the country in assists per game, but they're going to go against a tough, physical, gritty, man-to-man defense of Michigan State.
Today's starting lineups brought to you by Atlantis. Braden Norris works the point. Lucas Williamson is one of their go-tos as they look inside in an early block for Marcus Bingham Jr., the seven-footer, who's coming off a very strong game last time out. And this is what Loyola was afraid of, the speed of Michigan State getting down the court, but they can't convert.
One of the things that Loyola focused on in practice yesterday, they're sending three back in transition.
Norris averaging better than four assists a game. For Bingham.
Marcus Bingham has been the backstop of this Michigan State defense.
Now with 18 blocks on the season, had 19 points, 12 rebounds in his last game. Michigan State starting lineup brought to you by Atlantis. And here comes Loyola trying to find something in transition. Michigan State back quickly. And here at Ugwak.
Talk so much about the offense of Michigan State. Well, Loyola's, or the defense of Michigan State, Loyola's defense isn't too bad as well.
Norris on the turnaround. Can we make it three on Bingham? Tom Izzo has said about Marcus Bingham Jr., I think he has more to give. Well, he's been given plenty so far. Looking for the explanation on that call from our officiating crew as Michigan State brings it up.
Well, Bingham has definitely been the backstop defensively, and the other thing that Coach Izzo wants to see from Bingham is staying in the paint, finishing more inside, and there he does.
Bingham averaging 13 points, 8 rebounds a game. Big jump this season. He had 5 starts last season. Averaged 3.5 points and 3 rebounds, having a feast so far here. And now a turnover as Williamson throws it away. And tough going so far for Drew Valentine's team, the former assistant for 4 seasons to Porter Mosier, who's moved on to Oklahoma in his first season as a head coach. at age 30, the youngest head coach in Division I.
He was named when he was 29 years old. And I know the feeling of coming in, being young, you might feel like the new kid on the block. Well, not Drew Valentine. He had said when he was a GA at Michigan State, he would be in the office talking about, when I get my own program, this is what I'm going to do, or I'm going to do that. Well, now he has his opportunity.
Julius Marble comes into the game as Bingham goes to the bench. And Williamson's got a rebound for Loyola.
When Tom Izzo was asked about one of the things shocked about his team this year, he thought he'd shoot the ball better. Right now, they really struggled from the floor.
Loyola can't get anything going against this Michigan State defense here in the early going. And an open look for Tyson Walker, point guard in his first season with Michigan State after transferring in from Northeastern out of the Colonial. 7-0 run to start for the Spartans. Nothing coming easy for Loyola on offense so far. 6 possessions, 3 shots blocked, couple of turnovers and that miss, and now a 3 launched by Brown and pulled down by Loyola. Brown flies in and a foul is called on Loyola. Offensive foul called on the Ramblers.
Tyson Walker just steps right in. Can't go behind the screen on Walker. He'll make you pay.
Ugwuah gets called for the offensive foul. So it's a 1-2 punch at the point guard spot for Michigan State, with Walker getting the start, but A.J. Hogard comes off the bench and those two split the minutes.
Well, Hogard, they're two different types of point guards as well. Tyson Walker, he's a little smaller, but he's got a quick first step, where Hogard, he has the strength and size to get inside the defense, finish around the rim, play a physical.
Now, the point guards have struggled with turnovers through 4 games this season. Hogard turns that one over, trying to drop it down low, and here come the Ramblers, 0-for-4 from the field to start. Ryan Schwieger's in the game. He's been very good for Loyola as he fades and comes up short. Schwieger leading the team in scoring off the bench as Loyola trying to find something. Great start for Michigan State here in the Bahamas. 7-0 at the first timeout. ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by Bad Boy Mowers. Builds a better mower, mow with an attitude. By Atlanta's Paradise Island, Bahamas at heart. And Manscaped, level up your grooming game at manscaped.com today.
Where haven't we gone? What hasn't been done? What's still left to be discovered? And possible beyond the horizon? How can we continue pushing limits, breaking boundaries, and leading the way? At Bad Boy, it's not just about finding the answers. It's about the pursuit. Bad Boy. Mow with an attitude.
Come discover your secret place.
Hey, Tristan! Hey, Lexus, play holiday music.
We've been waiting all year to come together. Have a happy and safe holiday season from Lexus.
Rangers Bruins on ABC and ESPN Plus, Friday.
As I mentioned, 6 NCAA teams from last year in this tournament, including the defending national champions. Baylor ranked 6th in the country right now. They'll take Arizona State Later tonight, 3 in the preseason top 25. UConn now up to 22nd in the national ranking. And some star power emerging, some young emerging players and some coaches who just know how to win and answer the bell and the call year after year, including Tom Izzo.
Yeah, you got the young and the old, but Tom Izzo, he talked about coming to this tournament. He wanted to play a lot of different kind of teams. So you have the athleticism, the shooting team of Loyola. If they happen to face Syracuse, then you've got a zone team. You've got teams that'll press. There's a lot of different types of teams here in this tournament.
Here's Joey Hauser, did not play last game for Michigan State. More of a precaution, it sounded like, from Tom Izzo, dealing with a little calf problem. Says he's fine, was a full go yesterday here in the practice for Michigan State. Hogarth kicks into the corner to the elite shooter, Christie, who can't get this one, but a second chance here for State, thanks to the rebound by Hall. Well, a drop, but a trip to the line coming for Malik Hall, one of the co-captains for this Michigan State team, along with Gabe Brown.
And Malik Hall talks about this Michigan State team this year. What makes them so good is that they have multiple players who can play multiple positions, and Coach Izzo can play different lineups. So that's a scouting nightmare for any of the opponents they'll go against. You've got Hauser, who can play the three or the four, can interchange with Malik Hall.
Malik Hall, you see his number Saturday against Eastern Michigan, went for 15-9 in his first start, so getting his second straight start here for Michigan State. 9-0 out of the blocks here for the Spartans. Loyola 0-for-5 from the field so far with 3 turnovers. Tate Hall into the game for the Ramblers, working on Hauser. Make it 0-for-6. Hauser.
See, all of Michigan State's players, they're about the same size. They're large. They can switch on screens, really making it hard for Loyola to get anything open.
Easy rebound for Hall. And Michigan State's deep, too. They've got 3 players ready to come back into the game, including Bingham, who started the game with 3 blocks in the early going. Tipped out of bounds. Last touch by Hall. 18 to shoot for Michigan State. Coming up on Friday night, we'll have the Continental Tire Challenge. Number 5, Duke takes on number 1 with authority, Gonzaga, T-Mobile Arena in Vegas. 10:30 Eastern, 7:30 Pacific on ESPN and the app. One app, one tap. Gonzaga against number 2 UCLA last night. No
Handled
contest.
Them. Yeah, and but Duke, you've got Paolo Pinheiro, the freshman, who's made a big, big impact at Duke already.
Last night, 20-point win for the Zags. Chet Holmgren with 15 points, 6 rebounds, 4 blocks. And we'll join the chorus. We loved watching right at 10 o'clock Eastern time, watching Dickie V.
Oh,
Dave
so
O'Brien,
glad to have him back. It was awesome to see Dickie V.
You knew he'd be emotional, and then, just like Dickie V, flipped the switch and was right into talking about hoops.
It is game time, baby.
So the foul goes against Gabe Brown for Michigan State. That's the first team foul on the Spartans. Loyola trying to find a way to get something done offensively. Keith Clemens into the game now. Clemens is battling a knee problem. Schrieger, as I mentioned, he's been an outstanding scorer. That one will spin up. So it took 6.5 minutes, but Loyola gets on the board. And Loyola gets the stop on the other end. Offensive foul called on Brown.
But if you watch that, Tate Hall started to fall before the contact was made. He's already going backwards. That's dangerous. That looked like a flop to me.
So 2 personals on one of the starters for Michigan State, Brown. He's to the bench early. Marquise Kennedy Schwieger. Getting him back into the game with the rebound for Hogarth. Looks like Schwieger's going to get called for holding on to Hauser. That'll be his second personal foul.
Well, Hauser's a tough matchup because, yeah, he's got three-point range, but he can take you down. When he recognizes he's got a smaller guard on him, he'll go inside to the block.
Jaden Akins on the floor for Michigan State. So we've seen a couple of different combinations from Tom Izzo so far, using some of that depth. Christie. Akins, the freshman, hanging in the air, trying to tip it. Williamson. Walk. Good strong take, taking it right at Bingham, the shot blocker for his first two.
That's Ugwuok's first shot attempt. Expect more from him offensively for Loyola.
And you can see how quickly, and again, this is something Carolyn talked about, how Loyola in practice yesterday, they were so concerned, even off a make, getting back defensively.
They're going to send three back. Most teams will have one safety, maybe two, but Drew Valentine wants three back to try to stop that transition.
Timeout on the floor, 11:55 to go in the first half. We'll get to know the new Loyola head coach a little bit better. Caroline chats with Drew Valentine.
Get 25% off during Manscaped.com's Black Friday sale and save on all Manscaped products like all-in-one grooming kits, skin-safe trimmers, and great-smelling formulations. Go to manscaped.com to get 25% off site-wide plus free shipping.
The best leaders don't just forge ahead. They adjust. Bad Boy Mowers has made adjustments at every turn, including our revolutionary three-link suspension. Built tough and designed for superior performance and speed. Adjust the seat, handles, and pedals however you want. And as for Bad Boy's rebellious spirit, well, that hasn't adjusted at all. Bad Boy, Mo with an attitude.
We've all felt pressured into buying a store's overpriced electronics warranty. Upsea offers affordable and reliable warranties for all your electronics and appliances. Visit Upsea.com today.
Some things can't be tried at home.
Where next?
With Capital One, the possibilities are unlimited. Introducing Venture X, our new class of travel card. Earn 10x miles on hotels and 5x miles on flights booked through Capital One Travel. Plus, receive premium travel benefits like access to over 1,300 airport lounges. Find your where next with Venture X. What's in your wallet?
I'm here with Drew Valentine. This is the youngest coach in the NCAA. Hey, we're swimming with the Sharks. Does this give you any fear?
This does, and this tournament does give me a little bit too. So.
Well, you're playing a program that you have a lot of familiarity with. You were the graduate assistant at Michigan State. What other connections do you have with the Spartans?
I mean, so many. I grew up in Lansing. My mom is a graduate. Obviously, my dad played there from 84 to 88. Brother Denzel, National Player of the Year in 2016, and so the family ties run deep with the Spartans.
You told me earlier today, you had, when you were a GA in the back offices, you talked about when I ran my own program, is it what you thought it was going to be?
Definitely more. You know that, Coach. But, you know, it was so crazy just when this schedule came out, when I knew that I was, you know, going to be playing Coach Izzo the first game in Michigan State. I mean, so many good times, so many times where I really, you know, got my start and got my foundation in coaching. And so definitely don't like going against mentors or going against close friends, playing against them, but got to do it. And Battle for Atlantis is a great place to do it at.
Absolutely, and a great start and a young career. Hey, right. Have some fun this week.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much.
Well, it wasn't much fun the first five or so minutes, six and a half actually, before they scored. It was a 9-0 start for Michigan State against Drew Valentine's Ramblers, who seemed to be settling in a little bit. A couple of foul concerns maybe brewing for Michigan State as well. Brown on the bench with two. Bingham just picked up his first.
Like, imagine what Drew Valentine is feeling inside. I know it's like going against a mentor against Pat Summitt, and he has as much, if not more, respect for Tom Izzo. You want to win this kind of game.
Standing his ground defensively was Tom Welch. Well, I don't know how Michigan State fans are going to feel about this, but Carlton Valentine's got the Loyola colors today supporting his son. I can't blame him, though. Come on.
I talked to him before the game. Yep. He said he knew 100% who he was for today. The rest of the season, he'll pull for Michigan State. But his mom there, she's a school teacher. She went to Michigan State. His wife was just sitting to the left of Kathy. And his Drew Valentine's wife played volleyball
at Michigan State. So you got a lot of Michigan State alums. They know who to root for, and that's the Loyola head coach of his team right now.
Well, Drew told me he used to come to games and grew up in Lansing, East Lansing, getting autographed from Michigan State players.
Ball, open look for three. Well, Loyola's had a couple of open looks, just not dropping right on. We talked about the Valentine family with Carlton and Kathy. Don't forget, as Drew mentioned, one of the best to play at Michigan State, Denzel, who was then drafted by the Bulls, now with the Cavs. Drew was on Tom Izzo's staff as graduate manager, so there's those deep ties. Good lob inside by Norris. Loyola settling in here more and more. Down by five.
What Loyola is trying to do right now is establish the paint points. They know they've got the shot in their pocket from the perimeter. They've got to try to relieve some of that pressure from Michigan State.
Bingham showing the outside touch. Now 3 for 3 from the floor. He leads the Spartans with 6 points. Christy Williamson, deep three. Ball, good hustle play to get there and clean it up for Loyola. Here come the Ramblers. Big fist pump from Drew Valentine on the sideline, and not the same reaction from one of his mentors.
Well, that's that unforced turnover. Tate Hall stays after it, gets to the glass with the offensive putback. Michigan State then tried to get two back a little bit too quick, threw the ball out of bounds in transition.
Morris, good move by Ugwak, who continues just to glide down the lane. Student from Edmonton, who started his career in New Mexico, now has 4, and a blocking foul is called on Loyola. Ugwak taking the contact now in the 3-point game. We got a big day here for you. Carl Ravitch, Jimmy Dykes warming up in the bullpen, ready to go with Game 2. Auburn and UConn will be back at 5 o'clock Eastern for Syracuse and VCU. It should be a defensive battle. And then Baylor and Arizona State close things out tonight.
The game after us, though, it's the battle of the bigs. You've got Jabari Smith and transfer Walker Kessler from North Carolina going against Amada Sinogo and a cook inside for Connecticut.
Both very good defensive teams. Two teams that will really play hard on the defensive end as well. So that will be an interesting one to watch when we're done here. Inside of 9 minutes to go first half. Now the 3-point game. Oh, and the turnaround. Williamson will try another deep one. Not dropping for him yet, but another second chance here for the Ramblers. Jacob Hudson. He has 4. Hogarth has the handle. Now, after falling behind 9-0, Loyola with a chance to tie with a three, but Williamson takes it to the basket, but ripped away by the freshman Christie. And the lob for Hall. Williamson answers right back with a chance for a three-point play.
Put your track shoes on. Look, Loyola is here trying to gain respect against the Power Five. So they said, whatever you can do, Sparty, we can do as well. Just going back and forth in transition.
Strong take by Williamson after missing a couple of threes. Has a chance for a three-point play. Outstanding defender, second team all-conference last year in the Valley. Coming off a season best 16 last time out against UIC. He finishes the three-point play and will head to the bench.
Just a matter of time, I believe, to really shake a little cobwebs off for Loyola. Remind themselves they can play with Michigan State, and they've got themselves right back in this game.
You can see their biggest cheerleaders are head coach Drew Valentine trying to keep his team going, keep them up. He's a big energy guy. I mean, he's 30, so, you know, we all would love to have that 30-year-old energy. I'll only speak for myself. We saw you on the yacht. You've got a lot of energy. Sitting back there, relaxing. How about Michigan State?
They're
getting
off,
out in transition.
Off and running. Hogart to Hall, trying to keep the speed up for the Spartans.
Your total is 2515. Awesome. Here you go. Thanks. Oof, maybe time for a new card. Yeah, I know. I just don't know which one to get. Did you check out that Acorn Spend card? It's a debit card that saves, earns, and invests for you. How so? You can use it just like any other card, but every time you spend, it'll round up the cost and invest the spare change for you. And if you sign up now and set up direct deposit, you'll get a $75 bonus.
The Solo Stove Bonfire is the hottest new reason to get outside. With its signature 360 airflow design, firewood gets just the right amount of oxygen. And since it's easy to light, it gets going fast. It's America's favorite smokeless fire pit for a reason. Bonfire is made for when those good moments become lasting memories. Save $10 using promo code TV10 at solostove.com.
Introducing Standby Cash. Extra cash when you need it. Free when you auto-pay it back. New when you bank with Huntington.
At Zinc Health, we listened to Terry. He wanted his prescription to arrive at home, so we delivered it at no additional cost. We cared about Maria's health and financial needs, which is why we have an affordable out-of-pocket max. Like Terry and Maria, we see you getting the best Medicare Advantage plan. Optimizing your health with great benefits while spending less money. Amazing healthcare starts here. Join us today. Call 844-ZING for us or go to myzinghealth.tv.
Introducing Standby Cash. Extra cash when you need it. Free when you auto pay it back. New when you bank with Huntington.
Back here in paradise at the Atlantis Resorts. Pretty much this is the view you get everywhere you walk.
It's gorgeous here, absolutely.
Well, we've been watching Drew Valentine here. It's been interesting because he told us yesterday when it comes to his sideline demeanor, he likes to be more like Brad Stevens in his Butler days, a little stoic, a little laid back. We have not noticed that here today.
Oh, he has pounded on the scoreboard on the side. He's been up and down the court. I can tell you, you know, I remind you, I went against Pat Summitt, and I remember in that game, all the emotions were on my sleeve, running up and down the sideline. So you know Drew Valentine really wants to win this game when he's going against a mentor like Tom Izzo.
Out of the timeout, Christie feeds it to Marble, and that's going to be an offensive foul. Taking the contact was Tom Welch.
Welch rotates over. He's outside that restricted arc. Both feet on the floor. Good defensive position to take the charge.
First personal on Marble. Remember, Gabe Brown picked up a couple of early ones. He's been on the bench. Kennedy thought his teammate was going to be where he wasn't, intended for Chris Knight, who went to the basket. I mean, the things that are going to fire up a coach like Drew Valentine or any coach is guys taking charges, guys forcing turnovers like what happened just here, but then it's picked right up. You're going to know what happened. You can just watch the right side of the screen if you want to know what's happening for Loyola right now. It's going back and forth. And now the rebound pulled down by Christie.
I'm glad they got us some swivel chairs over here, Eric, so we can go back and forth.
A little easier in our vertebrae as we kind of go back and forth here like these two teams are trying to watch this.
Loyola has switched up now, going into a 3-2 zone.
Christie lost the handle. Valentine saying go, go. After falling behind 9-0, Loyola has come back to take the lead over Michigan State.
Patience. They've stuck to it. They grinded it out, attacking the basket, started running in transition, and now knocking down a three.
Inside of 6.5 to go with Loyola in front. Marble from the outside for two. Michigan State had committed 4 straight turnovers, Carolyn, before knocking down that shot.
We talked about Michigan State's defense, but Loyola's defense, they, in the last 25 games, have held opponents under 55 points.
Keith Clemens is the one who delivered the big shot, had not scored this season for Loyola. As I mentioned, battling a knee problem. The interesting thing, too, about Clemens, he's the oldest player on this roster. He's 24 years old, so he's very close. It's not shouting distance to his head coach. He's almost a peer to his head coach.
Now, they can relate. I think they see things eye to eye. And you watch Drew Valentine in practice, you see he's got a lot of comfort with coaching Clemens.
Kennedy ties it up at the free throw line. The junior from Chicago getting his first point. Sixth man of the year in the MVC last season, averaged 9 points a game. Those are his first 2 points here this afternoon.
And a lot is being asked of Kennedy. Coach Valentine wants him to be locked in, because when he is, he's really good.
Loyola back in that zone. Hogard trying to find an opening against it. Hauser hasn't scored yet. Lost the handle. Another turnover for the Spartans. That is their 9th. They have had trouble taking care of the basketball, averaging 15 a game in the early going this season.
The advantage that Drew Valentine has is he knows how Coach Izzo thinks. He knows about switching up the defenses, not allowing a team, if they're in a rhythm, to break their rhythm.
That's turnover number 8 for Loyola. Hogard, a nice clean strip. Great defense by Tate Hall. It was last touched by Hogard.
Hogard going hard to the basket. But Hall reaching in off the thigh of Hogard. That's how Loyola gets the basketball.
Michigan State already gets double digits in turnovers now with 10. Still 5 minutes to go in the first half. Williamson. Hudson. Tip back out by Williamson. Second chance here for the Ramblers.
See how Hudson has adjusted, getting his body into Bingham so Bingham doesn't have that spacing to elevate blocking shots.
Last touch by Loyola will be Spartans basketball. Today, the championship game for the Maui Invitational features Wisconsin and St. Mary's in Vegas. You can see it on ESPN 5 Eastern, 2 Pacific. Wisconsin knocking off Houston and St. Mary's shutting down the Ducks offense. So that championship game coming up a little bit later on today. Bad pass, turnover by Hogard, taking it all the way and losing it out of bounds was Hall. off his thigh. Michigan State with the basketball, 4:21 to go before halftime.
You see the adjustment that Michigan State is trying to make against that zone. If you can get the ball in the free throw line area, you give yourself options. Just Hogarth overpass, and you've got to use a pass fake. Make the defense have to shift. Hogarth's telegraphing all of his passes.
Open three off the mark from Norris. Been unable to get Max Christie going so far. Just 2 points on 1 of 4 shooting. Only 1 3-point attempt. And another turnover, 2-on-1 the other way. Norris to the basket. Hogarth stood his ground. Great fight, and a foul is called on Michigan State as Hall kept working hard for Loyola. And it has been a hard-working Loyola team here after going scoreless in the first 6.5 minutes of the game. They're up by 1 here in the first. ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by Lowe's.
The best way to watch college basketball on ESPN is with FuboTV. All the action, rivalries, and more. Streaming live on all your devices. The drama doesn't stop there. With over 100 top channels of live TV, try free at FuboTV.com.
We found a movement because we believe you shouldn't have to choose between a great watch and a fair price. Our watches are uniquely designed, in-house, clean, modern watches, crafted with top-tier materials. Join the movement now at MVMT.com.
Only Wendy's serves a better breakfast with a better biscuit. A hot, buttery treasure loaded with a fresh cracked egg, cheese, and sausage or bacon. And to top it off right now, they're just a buck. A buck? Now there's no reason to go somewhere else. Choose wisely. Choose Wendy's.
Grandma, how wide are two reindeer?
27, 28, 29...
We've been waiting all year to come together.
It
worked! Have a happy and safe holiday season from Lexus.
You have 3 burgers. You sharing, you eating all 3.
No, I'm eating them all.
You wouldn't share your burger with me?
Not this burger.
The burgers you make at your house? Yeah, we could share that. That's no problem. Sonic garlic butter bacon burger.
What if I'm hungry?
Absolutely not.
And it's NBA on ESPN time. I'm ready. Lego. Brian make the block with a Lego. Hate in his case club. Looking at the grave with the say so.
Tonight on ESPN.
What's up, everybody? Coach Fonz Dallin coming up on the Jeep Halftime Report. We live a special night last night. 1-2 Gonzaga, UCLA, and a special performance by the Bulldogs. Also previewing the great games coming up later on the air here today. Michigan State needs to remember they're wearing white in this game, right?
Are you suggesting that they're giving it to the other team?
Yeah.
I mean, they turned it over on 20% of their possessions, which is bottom half in the country. 13 turnovers in this game already, Seth. They got to take care of the rock.
Poor job about that. Finding the zone and attacking the zone. But more importantly, Tom Izzo, he's looking for an alpha. He's looking for a leader. He has not found one, and that reflects the way they're playing.
9 turnovers last 4.5 minutes. That is pretty wild. Back to Frito and Carolyn. We'll see you at the half.
All right, Dallin, I'm very impressed. Those guys were up late last night in Vegas. I don't think they went to bed. I'm doubting. I think they, you know, had the Gonzaga UCLA game, and then they're like, you know what? We're in Vegas. Let's go have a little fun.
Oh, oh wait,
we
got
what time do we got to be? They do not, especially during Feast Week. Well, they just talked about the turnover problems. I mean, Carolyn can break it down a little bit more for Michigan State right now.
Well, Fonz just talked about the turnovers. 9 turnovers in the last 10 possessions. That's not something Tom Izzo is looking for.
Tate Hall at the free throw line.
I think a lot of Michigan State inexperience at that point guard spot. Remember, he has 2 new point guards really running the point for him this year, and they're trying to push in transition. You got to play fast, but don't rush. And you've got to make good reads at a high rate of speed.
Tapped out of bounds by Loyola after the miss at the line by Hall. 18 fouls on Michigan State as the Spartans bring it up. Well, Spartans had trouble at the point last year, so they're hoping this 1-2 punch of Hogard and Walker, who transferred into the program, try to settle things down at that spot. Christie denied up top, and once again, Loyola on the run. Norris finds the trailer, Clemens, who gets the ball. Clemens, who has been limited this year, unleashed here in the Bahamas, 6 points in the first half.
We saw practice yesterday, thought that he was going to be able to be good to go today and given good minutes to the Ramblers.
Played just 1 minute last time out against UIC. Getting his first points of the season here today. Norris trying to feed that hot hand again. On the turnaround, and that one drops down for Chris Knight. The Dartmouth transfer gets his first points. Eight different scores now for Loyola. Remember, Michigan State scored the first 9 points of the game. Loyola didn't score in the first 6.5 minutes of this first half.
And you got to remember, Gabe Brown has been to the bench, having that in some free throw trouble, in some foul trouble.
Now the turnaround, Williamson with the rebound. Approaching 2 minutes to go in the first half. What a turnaround here for Loyola. Looks like they were going to get run out of the gym in the first few minutes, but they have played hard, they've fought through, and now they're on top by six. And a foul is called on Loyola as Clemens is whistled for.
Chris Knight, the transfer you talked about, comes inside off the ball screen, just slips into the open area, and then is able to go over Bingham. But then Loyola running in traffic again, finding Clemens, boom, splash. Three-point shooter, and that's smart. Find the hard hand, the hot hand.
Well, yeah, good look there. Clemens got across half court, and he was, I'm in shooting position. I'm ready.
I'm ready.
Hot.
Absolutely.
Pull the trigger. Let's go. Hogard will try a deep three. That's off the mark, and a rebound for Loyola. Loyola right now a plus two in rebounding margin. Williamson, corner three is good. And a timeout is called by Michigan State. Now down by nine after starting the game, scoring the first 9 points.
Tom Izzo had to call the timeout because he's got to figure out a way to cover the three. You got to get there. Otherwise, Loyola could open this thing up.
GMC Sierra, with hands-free driving, offers the most advanced and luxurious pickup in its class. Yeah, it rocks.
Lucas Williamson knocks down the three-pointer to put Loyola on top by nine, forcing the Michigan State timeout here in the Bahamas. And Loyola with a little pressure across half court against a Michigan State team that has struggled to take care of the basketball here in the first half. 14 first-half turnovers for the Spartans.
Well, and their leading scorer, Gabe Brown, had to go to the bench with a little over 13 minutes left.
Strong take by Malik Hall, who's leading the way with 8 points, and Gabe Brown's been leading the cheers on that Michigan State bench since picking up those two fouls. Final minute, first half. Loyola hasn't exactly been perfect when it comes to take care of the basketball. They've turned it over 11 times.
But you look at the stat sheet, one of the things that Loyola did is they established paint points. They have 14 in this first half. What does that do? That makes Michigan State take a step back, protecting that paint. That then does what? Allows Keith Clemens to be open or other shooters for Loyola to knock down the three.
Hogard in trouble. Got some help. And Michigan State finds Bingham. timeout with the shot clock off at 18.1 to go before halftime. Well, Bingham's had a strong first half, 8 points and five rebounds. Set the tone in the early going with those three quick block shots. We'll take you through what he's been able to do so far in the first half for the Spartans.
Well, they start out showing his offense, but he flexed early with his defense, like you talked about, Eric, with the block shot. But with his length, Bingham has the ability to go inside down low, and that's where Tom Izzo wants him. But he also has the range to knock down those long distance shots.
2 games ago, very impressive against Butler in that win at Butler. 10 points, 6 boards, 6 blocks for Bingham, as we mentioned before, really raising his game this year. Brings Michigan State within 5. Final shot coming here for Loyola. Inside, there's another block for Bingham, given 4 in the first half. Time here for Michigan State. Christie for 3. Halfway down. Usually those will drop for Max Christie, not this time. Well, high fives all around for Loyola after that slow start. 0 for 7 from the field to start. Didn't score until 6.5 minutes were played in that first half. And they head to the locker rooms here in the Bahamas with a 5-point lead. Michigan State strong early. Loyola stuck with it. And they are up by 5. Time for the Jeep Halftime Report. We go from the Bahamas to Vegas. Dallin, Seth, and LaFonso.
Thank you, Frito. This is the Jeep Halftime Report. This is the first time in 6 years I'm going to say this. I'm not jealous of them being in Atlantis at all. Because we're on the Vegas Strip, baby. We're right across from Caesars, our home for the week. It's the epicenter of college basketball this week. We are here
until Friday. You know, you can gamble there also. Just want to give you a little...
I'm well aware of my places that I can gamble. And we're going to talk about that a little later in our shows here throughout the course of the day. Get you some plays, get you whatnot. But this game has been fascinating. 28-23, Loyola's up right now. They've outscored them 28-14 in the last 14 minutes. What do you make of this last 20 minutes, Mike?
Well, I love Loyola's defense, and Seth mentioned it earlier. They're playing a gap defense, and Michigan State is just moving the basketball around. You've got to drive that thing, and when you draw 2, kick it again and redrive it, and Michigan State will be able to get some easy opportunities. But, Seth, it's the same thing we talk about year after year with Michigan State. 14 turnovers is way too many missing opportunities, and I think they missed Gabe Brown as well.
That was pathetic. I mean, it's pathetic. You talk about Michigan State and playing against a gap defense. They play against pack line defense all season long in the Big Ten. Mm-hmm. Move the ball, move people. You can't stand. You're driving a gap, that's one thing. They're going to help and recover. They're going to bluff in a gap and recover back. You got to cut hard. You got to screen someone. You got to run the ball into your hands. You got to be strong with the ball. You got to recognize defense. And then your ineptness offensively can't affect what you're doing defensively. No communication, doing a horrendous job defending that high ball screen, giving rolls to the rim. This will be very interesting halftime talk by Coach Izzo.
You know, like we said yesterday with Mick Cronin, maybe a bit of a Red Fox record. Because yesterday, UCLA was down 20 at the break against Gonzaga. It was not the game we thought we'd see in terms of competitiveness, but it was a special night because the guy that epitomizes college basketball was back in the building. When Dickie V is there, college hoops has begun, and it's a big night.
Great being here, Dave. I didn't want to cry. I can't believe I'm sitting here. This is really a big thrill for me. I want to thank all you people. Sent me so many great messages. ESPN, Jimmy Pitaro, all my buddies at ESPN. I want to thank certainly my family and all the fans. My, you've been unbelievable.
Dickie V in the middle of a battle with cancer right now, going through chemo, but on the sidelines for this game, 1-2 in the country. And it was a game we were so excited about. But from the jump, Gonzaga just dominated this thing in every aspect.
Yeah, their transition game. When you play against Gonzaga, the most efficient offense in the nation, you have to get back and set a wall, identify the basketball. That was problematic, Seth, all night long.
The block shot initiated their transition game. A bad shot initiated Gonzaga's transition game. The bigs didn't do a good job getting back. They did a poor job of containing Andrew Nembhard. He got anywhere he wanted, 24-6. He owned the tempo of the game. And right there, Chet Holmgren, he owned the interior and the front of the rim.
Holmgren had 15 points, 6 blocks on the game. Was an absolute beast in the inside and the outside, showing you everything he can do. Here, Fonz gets the block. And And that's one thing with a 7'5 wingspan. But then this.
But look at Miles Johnson. He's just jogging back. He just jogs back. He doesn't get ahead of the ball. Then he gets turned and goes right to the front.
Coach, I don't want to look at Miles Johnson there. I want to see the future number one pick.
But I'll tell you one thing. Mick Cronin's looking at Miles Johnson and shouldering that right now.
Yeah, no doubt about it. It was a heck of a performance, to say the least. They now have two top five wins, and they took care of Texas handily. They beat UCLA in impressive fashion, to say the least. Is the gap? Last year we kept talking about who's close to Gonzaga. Gonzaga, Baylor's and Gonzaga by themselves. Where are they at right now in terms of the gap with anybody else?
I'm a believer. Seth knows that for 2 years, I thought Baylor could have won it 2 years ago, and they brought that same team back last year. I was riding them and saying, look, when you play against Gonzaga, you have to be able to stretch the floor, and you have to have guys who can get to the front of the rim, because they didn't have a shot blocker or a rim protector during that time. Baylor proved that to be true by winning the national championship last year. The difference in this team this year, Seth, they can still shoot it as well, but they have a rim protector who's blocked over 20 shots in his first four games.
Look, Gonzaga's been terrific. There's no doubt about it. But, like, it's November, ladies and gentlemen, all right? They play Duke on Friday. We'll have a better understanding. Yes. Look, Duke has a chance. Purdue played as well as anyone against great competition this past weekend. Gonzaga playing at elite level. They beat in transition. The area they've improved is on the defensive end, not just rim protection. Mm-hmm. They have pressure on the basketball. Put great pressure on the basketball. They were really connected defensively. Gonzaga is phenomenal.
Yes.
Duke and Purdue are pretty good also, and other teams will emerge.
And we will see that Friday night, as Coach said, 10 Eastern here in Vegas. Duke against Gonzaga on ESPN. It's going to be a special week here. We got more stuff coming your way. We've got a Maui championship from here. We'll preview that next. Also, the next game in Battle for Atlanta.
You going to climb that mountain at halftime?
I'm ready to go. I'm fit.
Presented by the all-new 2022 Grand Wagoneer.
I definitely think mocha is an adult flavor.
Listen, the kids have their drink with candy.
Yeah.
I get my own drink.
This is our candy.
You know...
Espresso candy.
Sonic Mocha Crunch Blast. Espresso.
You say espresso?
Yes, I do.
Money is power. So with Boost Mobile, we help you find ways to keep more of it. Get 3 unlimited data lines for $30 a month each with a free 5G phone when you switch. All on one of America's largest 5G networks. More power to save. Boost Mobile.
You can get it if you really want.
Stop waiting. Start investing. E-Trade.
For the perfect massaging shampoo, we trained to hit 7 pressure points.
7 pressure points. 2 hands. 1 path to victory.
Remember your training?
Right here, people. Good stuff.
Forklifts!
All 7 pressure points, right?
It's delightful.
Seriously? But it's a total train wreck.
It's obvious that you've put a lot of work into it.
She's probably happy because she found out Honey Nut Cheerios can help lower cholesterol.
Does anyone want to go on a bike ride?
Slices and sticks. Half pepperoni pizza.
Half Italian cheese sticks.
This is more about the pizza.
No, it's more about the cheese sticks.
Pizza! Sticks!
Walk in and walk out at Little Caesars with hot and ready slices and sticks from 4 to 8 p.m.
Pizza, pizza.
Sticks!
6 days to Christmas.
Should we be worried?
I just gotta do one last thing.
Looks like Dad is going to be stuck at work for a little longer.
Hawkeye, only on Disney Plus.
Moving forward, Movado SE.
Hey guys, this is Joe, founder of Vuori, and I want to tell you about one of my favorite pants in the Vuori lineup, the Sunday Performance Jogger. The fabric on this jogger is absolutely incredible. It's got a more tailored, modern fit, making them super versatile, and it has a zip pocket to secure your belongings. Whether you're lounging around the house or you're putting yourself through a tough workout in the gym, the Sunday has you covered. And that's why the Sunday jogger is my everyday jogger.
You're watching the Jeep Halftime Report.
Coach Fonza Cuff back in our Vegas studio. Coming up next in the Battle for Atlantis, 2:30 Eastern, a top 25 matchup between UConn and Auburn. UConn 2.5-point favorites. Both teams unbeaten. The first time they're really tested playing a top 200 KenPom team. They've got to do it, Fonz. Big game.
Yeah, this UConn team is excellent. Great balance inside out. They played through Adama Sanogo on the interior, and I think that's where you're going to have to look. Whoever wins that matchup, you have Jabari Smith, the super freshman for Auburn, Walker Kessler on the interior. They have too much size, too much depth in the front court. UConn wins this game.
Yeah, UConn is obviously a dynamic team, but I'll tell you one thing. There's a championship game coming up. Mm-hmm. All right, in Maui, and it's not in Maui, obviously. It's here in Las Vegas. And when you think about it, Wisconsin, all right, Davis was absolutely phenomenal yesterday. I mean, you talk about making big shots, making big plays, playing on the ball, off the ball, their defense, they were in gaps, they were active, they were alert, they got deflections. Wisconsin was terrific. But they're playing against the St. Mary's team, the St. Mary's team that does not beat themselves. Four starting seniors, Dan Fotu, and his number is 42, all right, has been a matchup nightmare. The tempo of this game will be low. The number will be low, I suspect.
120.
I'm interested to see right now. St. Mary's, can they impose the tempo of the game on Wisconsin?
That's 5 Eastern on ESPN. A great slate of hoops coming your way all day.
This flag isn't backwards. It's facing this way because it's moving forward. Just like the men and women who wear it on their uniforms and the country it represents. They're all only meant to move one direction, which is why we fly it this way. On the flanks of the all-new Grand Wagoneer, moving boldly and unstoppably forward.
This Black Friday, do you want a TV? Or do you want the place on the TV?
Butter pecan.
Buttercream.
Butternut squash.
Butter garlic.
Better not come in here with that noise. Sonic garlic butter bacon burger. Baseball. Butter, 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 butter. Sweet butter. Butter.
Rare dead stock to the latest release, new or pre-owned, the drops never stop. eBay, authenticity guarantee.
I told you I was gonna win.
With Windows 11, gaming performs to another level.
Let's go!
And when it comes to streaming movies, we haven't really experienced any buffering. It's so cool that we'll have access to movie theater level quality pretty much anywhere.
Seeing it load up that quick, I was genuinely surprised.
I can't believe there's no lag. I didn't realize how bad you were until I got these really good graphics.
Dion, hand it over. Now, how does that make you feel?
Like a part of me is missing.
Gabrielle?
This Old Spice Fiji Hand and Body Lotion has me smoother than ever.
That's what it does.
Head over to Napa to prepare your ride for winter. Buy the 99-cent Napa bag and save 20% on 3 or more items. It's a great way to get what you need to battle the elements. When it comes to finding you great holiday deals, our motor never quits.
This halftime report is presented by the all-new 2022 Grand Wagoneer.
Beautiful scenes in Vegas. Atlantis has got some good stuff, too. Malik Hall's got 8 points. Here's 2 of them on the throwdown, but Sparty's down 5. Can they battle back? Can they stop throwing the ball away? We find out next. This has been the Jeep Halftime Report.
Where haven't we gone? What hasn't been done? What's still left to be discovered? And possible beyond the horizon? How can we continue pushing limits, breaking boundaries, and leading the way? At Bad Boy, it's not just about finding the answers. It's about the pursuit. Bad Boy. Mo with an attitude.
Only Wendy's serves a better breakfast with a better biscuit. A hot, buttery treasure loaded with a fresh cracked egg, cheese, and sausage or bacon. And to top it off right now, they're just a buck. A buck? Now there's no reason to go somewhere else. Choose wisely. Choose Wendy's.
Looks like Daryl's still looking for that money in his home.
Should we tell him he can just refinance with Rocket Mortgage?
Nah. Let's see where this goes.
When you want to find money in your home, Rocket can.
Oh, sorry.
Rocket.
Money is power. So with Boost Mobile, we help you find ways to keep more of it. Get 3 unlimited data lines for $30 a month each with a free 5G phone when you switch. All on one of America's largest 5G networks. More power to save. Boost Mobile.
The great thing about the app is we're going to get happy hour pricing on our drinks.
That's right.
No matter what time.
It's happy hour every hour.
Let's be honest. Anytime I see a discount, I'm going to go for it.
Right.
I don't care what it is. I have to have that.
Yeah. Anything that is half price tastes twice as good. Right?
Right.
Fill up on Thanksgiving savings at K&G. Buy 2 men's suit separate jackets, get 2 pants or vests free. Men's and women's sweaters and activewear start as low as 2 for $25. Plus, select men's and women's shoes are buy one pair, get one half off. Take home styles for less at K&G.
It's Menards' last 11% rebate sale of 2021. And now is a great time to update the floors in your home. Vinyl plank flooring is perfect for active lifestyles. It's durable, waterproof, and easy to install. Whatever your style, we carry the vinyl plank flooring for you. Finish your flooring projects before the holidays and save 11% on all vinyl plank flooring now during Menards' last 11% rebate sale of 2021.
Save big money at Menards.
Fill up on Thanksgiving savings at K&G. Buy 2 men's suit separate jackets, get 2 pants or vests free. Men's and women's sweaters and activewear start as low as 2 for $25. Plus, select men's and women's shoes are buy one pair, get one half off. Take home styles for less at K&G.
You're watching Feast Week, presented by Lowe's. This is the Bad Boy Mowers Battle for Atlantis. We played the first 20 minutes of this tournament. Oh, I can play this outdoors. That looks nice. I think some of the players would go for that, too. 28-23. Loyola on top of Michigan State. Eric Fried, courtside with Carolyn Peck. If you missed the very top of the telecast, Carolyn was on her yacht to start things off here. Now she's back with us. And if you've missed the first 6.5 minutes of the game, Loyola was down. They missed their first 7 shots. They were down 9-0, but things flipped quickly for the Ramblers in that first half.
Loyola kept going inside in the paint, and Marcus Bingham from Michigan State was blocking shots, but that did not deter the Ramblers from continuing to go inside. Look, they were telling their story. Their first part of that story is that they are going to get the paint points to try to relieve some of the defensive pressure from Michigan State, and once that was done, then Keith Clemens and Lucas Williamson came inside, came out, knocking down that 3-point shot.
Take a look at the first half numbers brought to you by Atlantis. We talked about the runs. It was a 10-0 run for Loyola to go back in front. Michigan State struggling in the final 10 minutes of the first half. And Loyola Chicago getting some work done from the bench. By contrast, Michigan State has just 2 bench points so far in this game. And a quick foul called 9 seconds in on Gabe Brown, who played just 5 minutes in the first half because of 2 fouls.
That's 14 points a game that's in some foul trouble for Michigan State. Tom Izzo is going to leave his leader, Gabe Brown, on the floor with 3 fouls.
Everyone had a hand in the scoring in the first half for Loyola. That's Norris taking it at the 7-footer, and his teammate Hudson cleaning up. 6 points now for Hudson, averaging just over 6 points a game. Walker. And a foul called on Loyola on the drive by the Michigan State point guard. Marquise Kennedy picks up the personal. Well, Brown held scoreless in the first half, as Carolyn mentioned, averaging 14 points a game. Bingham had 8 points in the first half, and now a turnover. A turnover, a big story, too. 15 turnovers now, and quickly down the court, Loyola turns the defense into offense with Williamson.
Norris, you would think that he was going to hit the player in the middle of the floor, but he finds the runner on the backside in transition.
This matches the largest lead of the game for Loyola, up by nine.
You watch the steal. Norris gets it, eyes up. It's almost like that volleyball fake where the first spiker comes through and the second one, Lucas Williamson on the backside to have that layup.
On the slide? Are you?
On the slide. It was a little trickeration.
You know your basketball? You've got it all. Brown, 4-3. First points for the senior.
That's what Michigan State's been missing. Gabe Brown has got his offense working this season.
Foul called on Bingham.
See, Gabe Brown has got great length on the perimeter. So he can see it, eye it, knock it down.
Trip to the free throw line coming for the sophomore from Edina, Minnesota. Good minutes off the bench last year.
The adjustment that Hudson has made from how he was getting his shot blocked early by Bingham is he's now bodying up, getting into the defense so that Marcus Bingham can't just take off and swat his shot.
7 points now for Hudson.
Loyola switching up now, going zone press into a half court zone.
Back to Brown. Christie held the 2 points in the first half. Brown off balance shot, tough one. And then batted out of bounds by Ukwok. It will stay with the Spartans. A lot of stuff on the outside for Michigan State. One number that also jumped out. They only got to the free throw line twice in the first half.
They didn't go very much in the paint. The only points off the bench came from Julius Marble inside.
Walker can't get it. Christie's got an offensive rebound. And another opportunity here for the Spartans. Walker put the floater. Back to a 5-point game. Reaching in and knocking it away is Bingham, who finds a teammate. The drive, Christie was fouled. Well done by the 7-footer Marcus Bingham.
Get after it. Get on the floor, big fella. Love those kind of hustle plays.
So he'll head to the bench, and Marble into the game will trigger the inbound for Michigan State. 3-1 on the season. Their loss was to Kansas in the season opener at Madison Square Garden. Carolyn, you were there in person in Manhattan for that matchup.
Yeah, the Michigan State defensively played very well. Just a couple of areas, one of which was turnovers, really cost the Spartans in that ball game against Kansas.
Marble gets called for a foul, setting a screen on Norris.
You see Julius Marble, he's moving into the defender. You just got to stay put. Let the offense, let your teammate use you.
Williamson, defended by Christie. The veteran working on the freshman with the fadeaway. It won't drop for Walker, but another foul called on Loyola. That will be foul number 4 on the team here in this half. And Ukwok just picked up his 3rd personal. Ryan Schwieger will come into the game. He was limited in the first half because of a couple of fouls. Play just 4.5 minutes. Christie couldn't control on the sideline. Some more sloppy play for Michigan State and another Spartan turnover.
And the unforced turnovers. You just got to make sure you can control the catch. It's 17 already. We still got a little over 16 minutes left to go.
Morris runs out of trouble and a foul is called on Marble. He picks up his third personal foul. So three on Brown, three on Marble. And that will get Bingham back up off the bench and into the game.
I believe having Bingham in the game allows the defense on the perimeter of Michigan State to get a little more aggressive, because you know you've got to have that safety net of Bingham to block shots.
Knight got Bingham in the air, and Bingham gets whistled for the foul. So the fouls piling up on each team. That's three on Bingham. 5-point game, second half. ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by Lowe's and the Sonic Garlic Butter Bacon Burger, for a limited time only at Sonic.
Welcome to Bedlam.
Oklahoma, Oklahoma State, Saturday on ABC.
The best way to watch college basketball on ESPN is with Fubo TV. All the action, rivalries, and more, streaming live on all your devices. The drama doesn't stop there. With over 100 top channels of live TV, try free at FuboTV.com.
We've all felt pressured into buying a store's overpriced electronics warranty. Upsea offers affordable and reliable warranties for all your electronics and appliances. Visit Upsea.com today.
Hey, Tristan! Hey, Lexus, play holiday music.
We've been waiting all year to come together. Have a happy and safe holiday season from Lexus.
This is Antonelli's Cheese Shop.
And we're the Antonellis.
Do good, eat good.
That's our mission.
We chose our new Spark Cash Plus card from Capital One because it gives us unlimited 2% cash back on everything we buy.
And it has no preset spending limit, so our purchasing power adapts to our business needs. We use our 2% cash back to help cover our employees' healthcare costs.
And that's how we take care of our most valuable asset.
Our people. It may sound cheesy,
but we like it that way.
What's in your wallet?
Doug. Superpowers from a spider bite. I could use some help showing the world how Liberty Mutual customizes their car insurance so they only pay for what they need.
Did it work?
Only pay for what you need.
Liberty, 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 liberty.
Spider-Man No Way Home in theaters December 17th.
Well, this is a scene we'd expect to see around the pools here at Atlantis. Bruce Pearl with his shirt off, but you know what? You can just look back October 9th. He had the shirt off at the Auburn football game. Who was most impressed? That's Cam Newton. You can tell by the hat, of course, because Cam's got thousands of them. So Coach Pearl has left the pool, put his shirt on, and he's ready to coach Auburn against UConn in our next game here at Atlantis.
You sure he's not at the top of that big Atlantis slide with his shirt off, little pregame activity? Oh,
there,
no.
There he is.
He's here.
He's ready to go. He's ready to go. He's got the beach beard going on. Got a little sun. He's got his game face on.
He hadn't started sweating yet, but that'll happen by halftime against UConn.
Yeah, against a Dan Hurley defense, I'm sure. He'd be sweating in the early going in that game. So you'll see that coming up at 2:30 Eastern here on ESPN. Fouls piling up for Michigan State here in this game against Loyola.
But now, remember with Loyola, Ahir Ugwat has gone to the bench with foul trouble. He's only scored 4 points today. That's almost 14 point a game player. Key part of the offense for the Ramblers.
One of two for Knight. Marble comes up short on the turnaround and batted out of bounds by Loyola. Saying it was deflected by the Ramblers and it'll be Spartans basketball. Drew Valentine disagrees. I'll take that back a little bit. Strongly disagrees,
I was
just to
say,
make it clear.
It's not just a disagree. You don't think this game means a lot to Drew Valentine?
Brown corner three is good. Gabe Brown has a couple of threes here in the second half, and he's brought Michigan State within three.
When you saw Gabe Brown, like, pat his hand down, like, now stay calm, because he's got to play. He's got three fouls. He's got to play smart and stay on the floor.
Williamson dropped it down tonight. Couldn't get it. And gets the foul.
Gabe Brown on the backside. Max Christie has a defense swinging to the left. Gabe Brown open on the right, able to knock down the three.
Three personal fouls now on Williamson. There come the Spartans, now down by one.
Tom Izzo to break a press, keeps the basketball in the hands of his leaders. Malik Brown, Malik Hall, and Gabe Brown.
First points of the second half for Malik Hall. He's leading the way for the Spartans with 10.
Those are his two captains for Michigan State, Hall and Brown.
Schwieger answers with a three. Excellent three-point shooter, 8 of 16 on the season in the first four games, comes up with a big three to put Loyola back on top by four. Clemens guarding Walker. Clemens hit a couple of threes in the first half. Brown's got an open look and he's got another three.
Michigan State has needed Gabe Brown on the floor. Only 4 minutes in the first half. He has been big now coming in the second.
Batted away by Walker, outstanding defensive player, the defensive player of the year in the Colonial, playing for Northeastern last season. He'll remain with Loyola.
You see Gabe Brown off the screen from Malik Hall. Not only the scoring is what Gabe Brown brings to the floor, but he also brings the emotion for the Spartans.
Norris, backboard drop. So Knight missed one on the inside. Norris misses on the drive, and Michigan State with a chance to go back in front. Instead, they turn it over. Another turnover for Tom Izzo's team. Now up to 18.
A missed opportunity right there. Michigan State able to take the lead, but another costly turnover.
Clemens is bumped by Brown.
It's huge.
Tom Izzo buries his face in his hands because Brown, who's helped lead this comeback, has just picked up his fourth personal.
What a smart by Keith Clemens. As soon as Brown got on it, to attack.
Aikens, the freshman, with the block. Here's Malik Hall. Beautiful dribble to the basket. And one.
Izzo looking for that alpha guy. Malik Hall has become that today. Stepping up big. Gabe Brown has to go to the bench. His co-captain, Malik Hall, has stepped up big to take the lead for Michigan State.
Hall has been perfect. 5 for 5 from the field, 2 for 2 from the free throw line. Adds another 13 points for Hall. Co-captain for this Michigan State team. His fellow co-captain, Gabe Brown, leading the cheers for this big Spartan crowd that's made the trip to the Bahamas. Spartans back in front. Ubwak back into the game playing with 3-4 Loyola. Clemens, another one that won't drop, a big time follow by Ahir Ubwak and a chance for a 3-point play.
Ahir Ubwak is out on the wing, but watch, slashing down the middle of the paint. Doesn't come down with it, right back up and draw the foul. Watch, left side coming in, straight down the middle, untouched. Nobody checks out Ubwak, and he's there for the putback.
And finishes the 3-point play. Foul on Hall for Michigan State. That's his first.
Loyola back into the zone. 2-3.
Hogarth on the take. Batted around and into the hands of Ubwak. Kennedy with the kick. Clemens can't keep it going in the second half, and Hauser with the rebound. Christie, good find to Hall. Now for Hall, a perfect 6 for 6. Christie with a couple of assists today. Williamson had plenty of time on the shot clock. Someone was counting down the shot clock a little inside of what the number was, and he put up a deep three.
You can't listen to the crowd. Keep your eyes on the clock.
Hogarth. And a reach-in foul called on Kennedy. And that will get us to a timeout. 11:03 to go in the second half. Michigan State fell behind at halftime, but they are rallying back here in the Bahamas.
Thanksgiving Showdown, Rangers Bruins on ABC and ESPN Plus, Friday.
Here we go. Halfway through the NFL's biggest season ever. Stay tuned.
Reggie Bush used to eat breakfast somewhere else, but then he tried Wendy's breakfast.
Woo, baby, that's how you crack an egg right there.
He doesn't even watch football anymore.
Did y'all see this croissant? Who saw this croissant?
Choose wisely. Choose Wendy's.
When you spend all year serving others, when you lead by example, you don't just land on the nice list. You get rewarded by becoming the top brand in new vehicle quality in the automotive industry. Celebrate all the good you've done this year at the Ram Black Friday sales event.
Get one full year of no extra cost SiriusXM on us and 0% financing for 72 months plus no monthly payments for 90 days on the 2021 Ram 1500 Bighorn.
Money is power. So with Boost Mobile, we help you find ways to keep more of it. Get 3 unlimited data lines for $30 a month each with a free 5G phone when you switch. All on one of America's largest 5G networks. More power to save. Boost Mobile.
You have 3 burgers. You sharing, you eating all 3.
No, I'm eating them all.
You wouldn't share your burger with me?
Not this burger. The burgers you make at your house? Yeah, we could share that. That's no problem. Sonic Garlic Butter Bacon Burger.
What if I'm hungry?
Absolutely not.
Michigan State has outscored Loyola 18-12 in the second half, and Malik Hall is having a game.
Well, the versatility of Michigan State. Now Malik Hall is running the four, but watch this. He recognizes once the ball gets to Christie, there's nobody in the paint. He continues in transition. Christie finds him wide open down low for the easy two.
So Malik Hall, perfect 6-for-6 from the field. Bingham's 4-for-6 from the field. Rest of the team is 7-of-26. So Hall doing what he can to bring the Spartans back in this game. A.J. Hogard will head to the free throw line.
In the press conference yesterday, Gabe Brown and Malik Hall were asked about what was unique about this team. Gabe Brown talked about how connected they were. They do things both on and off the court. And it was Malik Hall that spoke up and said, "And we are versatile. We can put on a lot of different lineups. We can play a lot of different positions. It makes them a tough matchup for their opponents."
Hogard with the front end of the 1-on-1, 17 fouls on each team. Norris looks for the lob inside, a little too high for Hudson to handle. Hauser has not scored here today, but he'll have a chance as he'll go to the free throw line to shoot 1-on-1. Foul on Hudson.
Well, this is a tough matchup right now because Michigan State really has five guards on the floor. Hauser can play that three and knows he's got the ability to go off the bounce off against Jacob Hudson.
Hauser in his second season with the Spartans. Gets his first point of the game. Started 16 last year, averaged almost 10 points a game. It's such a tough year, though, because you transfer into a program in a COVID year when, as we all went through it, it just was not an easy transition for people going into new programs. So Hauser probably will be a little bit more comfortable this year for Michigan State.
Well, he's got a year under his belt. He understands his role. He's been able to work on his game, understand the philosophy of what Tom Izzo wants, and now he's right in the flow.
Foul called on the Spartans. Aikens picks up his first. A lot of free throws come the rest of the way. Both teams already in the 1-on-1. As Keith Clemens steps to the line.
Michigan State shoots 73% from the free throw line.
Norris, good steal, had the hands in on the Hauser pass. Behind the back pass goes awry, but Clemens trying to help out. He lost the handle. Hauser couldn't get it. Out of the scramble, they find the open shooter. Williamson with a dribble to get free, and that won't drop.
Holy cow! LeBlanc, where did you come from?
Norris cashes in for three. Give the big assist to Ugwuoke on the offensive rebound. First points for Norris after he missed his first six field goal attempts.
Try to stop Michigan State getting inside the zone.
Corner three, Michigan State trying to beat the zone from the outside. That's Walker with the triple.
Tom Izzo said he felt like he had a better shooting team this year. Walker has stepped up.
Michigan State is 4-for-5 outside the three-point line here in the second half. Norris will try again. Deliver. Hall. Everything's dropping for Malik Hall here this afternoon in the Bahamas. 7-for-7 from the field, 17 points.
Well, you see his versatility. We saw him in the paint that time, catching on the perimeter, taking it off the bounce. Nice little fadeaway.
Hall now 2 points shy of a career high. Williamson was fouled by Hogard. On the way up, so two free throws coming for Williamson.
Well, Hall just so strong and so big, takes it hard to the baseline and then pivoting back to the middle just to create enough space.
Hogard picks up his first personal foul. And here is Lucas Williamson. Williamson, a connection to that Final Four team for Loyola. 3-year starter for this Rambler squad. Standing on the defensive end. And a contributor offensively. He's into double figures now with 10. Leading Loyola in scoring this afternoon in their opener here on Paradise Island. Saw Williamson take a tumble there, so they want to make sure the floor is mopped up here. Wow. Malik Hall now with 19 points. That matches his career high.
He's been the most effective of the Spartans this season. And just playing so strong. Finishing over Uguac.
3-point lead for the Spartans. Norris looks for the lob. Uguac makes the extra pass. Great block by Bingham, but sticking with it was Knight. Back to a one-point game. Gabe Brown, not this time. Last touch by Bingham. It'll be Loyola basketball when we come back. UConn Huskies getting ready to go. 22nd ranked team in the country. They'll take on 19th ranked Auburn after we're done.
Where haven't we gone? What hasn't been done? What's still left to be discovered and possible beyond the horizon? How can we continue pushing limits, breaking boundaries, and leading the way? At Bad Boy, it's not just about finding the answers. It's about the pursuit. Bad Boy. Mo with an attitude.
This may sound mad, but the Zags might be bluer than the Blue Bloods.
Spokane, one of the epicenters of college basketball.
And we all thought this guy would coach forever, right?
As good as anybody who's ever coached this game.
Two great teams.
Gonzaga and Duke.
Two diaper dandies.
Holmgren is a unicorn.
And Carroll. We're going to see these guys in the green room of the NBA draft.
Experience. Number one Gonzaga, number five Duke. Friday at 10:30 on ESPN.
Get 25% off during Manscaped.com's Black Friday sale and grab your favorite Manscaped products for that special someone. Like our Performance Package 4.0 all-in-one grooming kit. Or get them something that will surely make a splash with the Lawnmower 4.0 waterproof trimmer. Looking to sniff out a great deal? Get the Weed Whacker ear and nose hair trimmer. And all our Manscaped formulations, like our Crop Reviver Ball Toner and Crop Preserver Ball Deodorant. Go to Manscaped.com to get 25% off site-wide plus free shipping.
Michigan State with a one-point lead, but Michigan State has Malik Hall. And Michigan State talks about him like I do you, Eric. OKG, he's our kind of guy. He can do it all. He is perfect from the floor right now. 8 for 8. He is 3 for 3 from the three-point line, and he has been a go-to for the Spartans.
Michigan State was down by 5 at halftime. They are up by 1, 7:33 to go here in the second half in our opener, the first of 12 games at Atlantis, tying the career-high 19 points. Perfect day from the field, as Carolyn mentioned.
Well, here's the other thing that has changed for Michigan State. The first half, they were 1 for 7 from the three-point line. Second half, 4 for 6. And who has a lot to do with that? Gabe Brown. That foul trouble kept him on the bench, but Tom Izzo has him back on the floor right now.
Well, Brown out there with the 4 personals. Ball shut off by Christie. Dropped it in the net, rejected by Bingham. 6 blocks now for Bingham. Norris back the other way for Loyola. Off the window, Loyola's missed a couple in close here in the second half.
Michigan State needs to play through Gabe Brown and Malik Hall.
Step back won't go for Walker.
Good box out by Chris Knight on Bingham.
Norris will try another 3. No good. Brown's the one who tipped it. And Walker will slow things down.
Had a mismatch. Norris had got caught on Malik Hall, but Tyson Walker didn't see it.
Hall was hit by Tate Hall. He'll go to the free throw line. Tonight's NBA doubleheader starts in Boston, 7:30 Eastern. The Nets will take on the Celtics. Then the Warriors will host the Sixers. Our coverage starts with NBA Countdown at 7. Perfect way to start your Thanksgiving Eve. We've got you covered with college hoop all day long. Got some NBA tonight. Get a good night's sleep. Get ready for Thanksgiving Day.
Stretch some pants.
Stretchy pants.
Get your stretchy pants out.
That's my default setting, but, you know. Maybe I got extra stretchy for Thanksgiving.
I'm going back to the yacht. I got an invite.
How did you get on that yacht? Because that's not some little Zodiac, some little dinghy. Well, there aren't any of those here in the harbor.
I can tell you all my connections to the inspiration.
Well, Malik Hall has earned a spot on that yacht if he wants it after the game, because he's been fantastic. A new career high. 21 points, 8 for 8 from the field, 5 for 5 from the free throw line. He gets a rest here for a little bit in a 3-point game.
You keep playing like that, he'll be able to buy one of those yachts.
Foul called on Christie. Will send Williamson to the free throw line. Double bonus the rest of the way for these two teams.
Michigan State shoots the free throws a little bit better than Loyola has this season. Loyola's just a little bit better than 62-63%. Michigan State around 73% from the line.
Williamson's got 12. 9 different scores for Loyola here today. Christie's been held in check, just 2 first half points. Bingham. Hogard working with Bingham through traffic, tried to drop it down to him, and it's a turnover. That's 20 turnovers now for Michigan State. Loyola answers right back with a turnover of their own. That's 14. It was not tipped. The officials talked it over. State ball. Talked about Drew Valentine in his first season as Loyola's head coach. Grew up around the Michigan State program in Lansing. Going up against Tom Izzo and the Spartans. Hogarth goes down, doesn't give up, and finds an opening.
That's what you call stick to it. A.J. Hogarth slips, loses his balance on the floor, but doesn't quit, doesn't complain, doesn't even beg for mercy, but just gets back up and then takes it in for the two-hand slam.
Hogarth's first field goal of the afternoon. With Michigan State back on top by three with 5 minutes to go. Officials stopping play. We had the stoppage after the Hogarth dunk to mop up the floor, and they're going to do it again here just to make sure. Try to protect the players here. 19 on the shot clock for Loyola.
Looks
like we're all set.
As a coach, you want the players to be safe, but this kind of stoppage, though, stops your momentum a little bit.
4:53 to go. Loyola fell behind 9-0 at the start. Didn't score in the first 6.5 minutes of the game. Ran back on Michigan State. They had a 10-0 run in the first half. They were up by 5 at halftime. Williamson, beautiful little move for two.
This game has an NCAA tournament feel to it. Now these two teams are going after it. It's only November.
Plenty of time on the shot clock here. Hogarth rejected by Ubrak. Bingham flips it up. Controlled by Loyola, closing in on 4 minutes to go. Williamson again to the basket to put the Ramblers in front.
Paint points right now. That's what Loyola has gone back to, not just relying on that three-point shot.
Hauser knocks it down. Joey Hauser, his first field goal of the afternoon. Rebound for Hauser. Malik Hall will come in for Michigan State. Next stoppage. Dave Brown still out there playing with the four fouls. Hogarth can't get the runner. Ubrak has it for the Ramblers, down by one, inside of 3 minutes to play.
Yeah, it has not been A.J. Hogarth's night. You see Tyson Walker going to the table now for Michigan State.
Williamson lost the handle, got it back. It was deflected, according to the officials. Shot clock at 7. Norris can't get it. Bingham has the rebound, and Hudson gets called for the foul. Two free throws for Marcus Bingham Jr. when we come back with his Spartans on top by one. ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball brought to you by Bad Boy Mowers. Build a better mower, mow with an attitude. Movement, premium watches and accessories that don't break the bank. And Fubo TV, watch live sports and TV. Try free at FuboTV.com.
We found a movement because we believe you shouldn't have to choose between a great watch and a fair price. Our watches are uniquely designed, in-house, clean, modern watches, crafted with top-tier materials. Join the movement now at MVMT.com.
I need 3 garlic butter bacon burgers.
Coming right up.
Will someone grab me some more cheese?
Keep that garlic butter coming.
Burger up.
Order up. Sonic garlic butter bacon burger.
Money is power. So with Boost Mobile, we help you find ways to keep more of it. Get 3 unlimited data lines for $30 a month each with a free 5G phone when you switch. All on one of America's largest 5G networks. More power to save. Boost Mobile.
Grandma, how wide are 2 reindeer?
27, 28, 29.
We've been waiting all year to come together.
Ew, work!
Have a happy and safe holiday season from Lexus.
Only Wendy's serves a better breakfast with a better biscuit. A hot, buttery treasure loaded with a fresh cracked egg, cheese, and sausage or bacon. And to top it off right now, they're just a buck. A buck? Now there's no reason to go somewhere else. Choose wisely. Choose Wendy's.
Sebastian, this second game in the tournament between UConn and Auburn. UConn, a big physical, like, they're kind of built like you, actually, Sebastian. Big physical team. Yeah, thank you very much. Auburn, on the other hand, man, they like to rip and run up and down the floor. Both teams have a lot of depth, highly competitive coaches. This is going to be a classic game, Sebastian. This is going to be a classic game. Yes, it is. Yes, high five me, low fin me, whatever it is. Yeah, I agree.
Well, the expert analysis from Jimmy Dykes and Sebastian starting early as they get ready for Auburn-UConn, which comes up 2:30 Eastern time here on ESPN.
High five, low fin.
Low fin. I like that. I like that.
That's going to be a fun game.
Sebastian's got fish breath, but Jimmy didn't back down. Like, Jimmy was right in there just getting the analysis from Sebastian.
I think Sebastian whispered something in Jimmy Dykes' ear when he leaned over.
Sebastian doesn't strike me as a whisperer, though. So that's coming up. Carl and Jimmy standing by to bring you game number 2 of 4 that we'll bring you today. We're getting things started with a pretty good one here this afternoon. 2:28 to go. Bingham to the free throw line to shoot 2. First trip today, 9 of 12 on the season. He's matched his career high with 6 blocks this afternoon, had 3 in the opening minutes of the game.
Well, Bingham's had a big presence inside, but when Michigan State made their run, they were taking care of the basketball. They had all 5 guards on the floor, played really without a true center.
20 turnovers for Michigan State. They had 14 at halftime. To get the 2.
You just notice every time Hudson gets his body into Marcus Bingham, it's a little tougher for Bingham to block his shot. Bingham's on a career night with 6 blocked shots already.
Inside of 2 minutes to play in a tie game. Walker. Open look. Hall hasn't missed today, and he still hasn't missed today. Career high 24 for Malik Hall. 9 of 9 from the field. That's his first 3-pointer that he's tried today. Morris answers back with a 3. Braden Morris, his 3rd 3, all coming after halftime, and we're tied again.
Came down a little funny, a little gingerly. It looks to be okay. He retied up that tennis shoe.
Christie, final minute now. Christie fading away. Just 2 points today for the heralded freshman for Michigan State. Morris looks over to Valentine and wants Loyola to keep going. No timeout here as Norris works against Christie. The floater is short. sticking with it and fighting is Hall, but Bingham's there to snuff it out. Shot clock off, and Michigan State will take a timeout. 16.3 to go, and the Spartans got the stop defensively. They'll have a chance to win it when we come back to Atlantis. Great start for us here at this tournament.
The road home for the holidays, where the ultimate driving machine becomes the ultimate cruise through three states machine. The ultimate zip around the corner for mom's cooking machine. And even the ultimate we couldn't get out of there any faster machine. Because at BMW, we know every holiday looks different. So we created the ultimate whatever your road home looks like machine. Receive a credit of up to $2,500 through November 30th.
I need a Mocha Crunch Blast, please.
You got it.
I'm on the Mocha Fudge.
We're gonna need more espresso chunks.
Order up.
Sonic Mocha Crunch Blast.
This Black Friday, do you want a TV? Or do you want the place on the TV?
Amazing. Jerry, you gotta see this.
Saying it. Trust me, after 15 walks, it's a little old.
Stop waiting. Start investing. E-Trade.
Our playbook has countless guys' hairstyles because we know no two guys are ever alike. Good fading. Oh, great texture. Less pomp, more adore, Brittany.
Got it.
Hey! Nice haircut!
Forkless!
What a pleasant morning! It's warm, but not too warm. Why is he so happy?
He's happy because he found out Honey Nut Cheerios can help lower cholesterol.
So, I propose a quiet, meditative walk through nature.
Yes, go Sante!
Slices and sticks. Half pepperoni pizza.
Half Italian cheese sticks.
This is more about the pizza.
No, it's more about the cheese sticks.
Pizza sticks.
Walk in and walk out at Little Caesars with hot and ready slices and sticks from 4 to 8 p.m.
Pizza, pizza.
Sticks.
What a Thanksgiving week lineup we have in store tonight. The Warriors take on the Sixers. Game two of our NBA doubleheader. Thanksgiving night, the Egg Bowl, Ole Miss and Mississippi State. Friday, Rangers, Bruins, TD Garden in Boston. Then Saturday night football, Bedlam, Oklahoma, Oklahoma State. Great lineup to be thankful for. We're thankful for a great game here. 61-61. What's the play here for Michigan State?
Carolyn Peck. You got to play through Malik Hall. And even using Malik Hall in a ball screen action, you got to believe that Loyola's going to switch all screens. Put Jacob Hudson in a screen. He's got to make a decision. Does he stay with Hall? If he does, then you're going to have lob action. Get the two. You just need to win by one. Go to Bingham. Go into the glass.
Hall to Walker. Here we go. Down to six. Walker looks for the lob and delivers to Bingham. Here's Norris for the win from half court. Off the mark. And Michigan State wins the opener at Atlantis. Spending an extra moment with the former graduate manager at Michigan State, Drew Valentine, the Loyola head coach. What a game. Michigan State pulls it out. They go with the lob to end it.
Walker off the ball screen, re-screen. DeMarcus Bingham just throw it up around the rim. The big fella knocks it down. A perfect assist by Tyson Walker off the re-screen. You watch Marcus Bingham above the rim and cans it, knocks it down for two and for the win.
One more look. The only field goal of the second half for Bingham came with 4 seconds to go. executed to perfection. Tom Izzo with the hands in the pocket. I've been through this before. This is how we drew it up. And Drew Valentine so close to knocking off his hometown team, but his team represented themselves well. But now they will head into the other half of the bracket. Michigan State moves on. They will take the winner of our next game. That'll be tomorrow afternoon. Auburn and UConn. Loyola will take on the loser of the 5 p.m. game between Syracuse and VCU. Take a look at our player of the game brought to you by Bad Boys Mowers, and a perfect performance from the junior co-captain Malik Hall, 9 for 9 from the field, 5 for 5 from the line, 24 points, 7 rebounds. Let's not forget what Bingham did today. He had the game winner, 11 points, 9 rebounds, a career high, 7 blocks in the victory for Michigan State. Pretty good way to start, right? Pretty good way to start.
What's your appetite for Thanksgiving?
I'm ready. I'm ready to eat. Michigan State wins it here in Atlantis. For Carolyn, I'm Eric. We'll see you later.
Thanks, Frito. Welcome to College Basketball Live Scoreboard Show. We are on the beautiful, sunny Las Vegas Strip. We're here all week. We got here yesterday for Gonzaga, UCLA. It's the epicenter of college basketball right now with the Maui Invitational. Final coming up later today. Duke Gonzaga ends things on Friday. But Atlantis is pretty good right now, too. That's Coach Seth Greenberg, Alfonso Ellis. I'm Dallin Cuff. Outstanding game to start off the battle for Atlantis. That last play, like Michigan State, get a timeout, draw it up. Take us through it, Coach. What did you see?
You know, all of us expected the ball to go to Malik Hall.
Yes.
All right, high middle ball screen, a re-screen because they were going under Tyson Wheeler. They forget to tag Bingham, and Wheeler makes a great decision, throws it where the defense can't get it. Here's the play right here. You're going to see Malik Hall is going to space out on the right-hand side. He's going to clear, which opens up the floor. Here comes the ball screen. See, he re-screens it, draws two, no tag on the roll, throw it where the defense can't make a play. Really good decision. Nice job defensive transition. Contesting that last shot. Great win for Michigan State. Really tough loss for Maryland.
Yeah, able to overcome 20 turnovers. We talked about it, and here's that play again, Seth, and you talked about it. I mean, what a great decision by Tyson Walker to throw it where no one else could get to it. But this is a Michigan State team that I do feel has the potential to be a top 25 team if they can just take care of the basketball. 14 turnovers in the first half, 20 for the game. That's not going to get it done long-term in the Big Ten nor in the NCAA tournament.
I'll tell you one thing. If Malik Hall plays the way he played today,
yeah,
the emergence of Marcus Bingham playing
yes
at the rim, above the rim, protecting the rim. But Malik Hall, you look at Malik Hall, 6'8", got a skill, can make a shot, can post him, versatile offensively.
Yeah.
Malik Hall's got to be a guy that becomes their alpha offensively. And he's got everything you need. He's got versatility. He can play 3 and 4. He rebounds the basketball. He runs the floor. Here's a guy, look, he can bang in a post. And that's a big-time step-back jumper, a la LaFonso.
I love that one.
Can drive it and play through contact. Can shoot the three. Malik Hall, right there. That's your potential. Now the challenge for Malik Hall is, can you be that guy consistently, Fox?
Yeah, and I think you're right, Seth, because Gabe Brown got in foul trouble early in this game. And I've said all year long, for Michigan State to be an elite-level team, Gabe Brown needs to give them about 15 points, about 6 rebounds. He got in foul trouble early, needed somebody else to step up, and your guy absolutely went to work. The versatility that you spoke of, if a situation occurs like it did today where he gets in foul trouble, now all of a sudden Malik Hall can step in and actually have a mismatch because he'll have a smaller guy that they can actually post him. Love that. Love that.
Hall, Gabe Brown, Bingham, Hauser. That's a solid front court.
Yes.
Now they've got a consistency in their backcourt. Mm-hmm. And I think Walker making that play, Dylan, was a really big play because he needs something good to happen to him to gain some confidence. The other area of Michigan State's got to improve in their ball screen defense. Yep. Those guards were melting on that ball screen. Mm-hmm. You've got to whip that ball screen, get over the top of that ball screen, and get back in front of the basketball.
Yeah.
So, look, Tom Izzo is going to have this on tape. He's going to be able to build on it. Easier to build on it after a win. I don't care how nice Atlantis is. Let me tell you something. If you're 0-1, it's not that nice.
On that note, I was thinking the same thing. Always better to learn from winning game tape, particularly for players. It makes it a little bit easier, definitely for coaches too. Hall was about a perfect game. 9 for 9 from the floor, 5 for 5 from the free throw line. Bingham had 7 blocks. They got it done. Let's talk Loyola Chicago real quick here, too, because this is a brand name now. The country has become aware of a recent year's Final Four, Sweet 16, beating a team in Illinois in the tournament last year. Tough loss for Denzel, for Drew Valentine. Mm-hmm. He has obviously familiarity, former
just
coach
tough
there.
Tough loss for Denzel, too.
I'm sure. I didn't appreciate that either, despite being a Michigan State former star. But what do you see in the future for this Loyola Chicago team, not just in Atlantis, but as you look long-term?
Well, they had some turnover issues themselves. I mean, it was a really sloppy game. I think they ended up with 14 turnovers in this game. But what's always good for them is you can rely on two things for Loyola Chicago. They're always going to be really good defensively. There's a reason why Michigan State turned that basketball over 20 times. And so they're always going to be an elite-level three-point shooting team. This team is, I think, 13th in the country in three-point field goal percentage, like 43% per game. So when you combine a great defense and the ability to be able to spread dribble penetration, you can't help. You got to make them take tough twos, which they were able to get some. They were able to get some threes in transition late and able to kick out on some. I think this is a very dangerous Loyola Chicago team. Different without Krutwig.
Krutwig is a big difference. Look, they got four seniors. They got one senior that went to the Final Four. They've been to an Elite Eight. Norris is an elite physical ball guard, point guard who can make a play, not afraid to take big shots. Lucas Williamson's an elite defender. This is a very good basketball team, right? In a new environment with a very young, talented coach. I mean, yeah, we talk about 30 years old, but think about the apprenticeship that Drew Valentine has experienced. Worked for Tom Izzo, all right? Worked for Porter Mosier. Mm-hmm. Understands and the identity and the culture of that Loyola program. He's going to do a great job. Tough loss for them. Mm-hmm. I like a senior team. I like the maturity. They'll deal with this, all right? Adversity reveals character, and obviously this team is high character. Mm-hmm. So I think they'll be fine. Here's the key for them in terms of big picture. Mm-hmm. Go get some players because those four seniors leave. Yeah. You got to replace those guys. Right. I think they'll be good in the portal. Loyola's going to be just fine. Moving into the Atlanta 10.
And moving into the A-10, and they've got a big opportunity tomorrow. They're going to play the loser of UConn, Auburn, a top 25 team, so another chance to play another quality opponent. We are in Vegas, as you can see across the hall and across the street there, Caesars Palace, beautiful Caesars Palace. Mm-hmm. And
why we're here. It's expensive.
No, let's not get into that right now. The prices out here are bananas. But it's a special event here all week. Feast Week's been great. Special night last night. Gonzaga playing UCLA 1-2, and it's a big game. And the voice of college basketball, Dickie V, was back in the building. In the midst of his cancer battle right now, chemo treatments, but still, he was there on the sidelines. It was emotional. It was awesome.
It's great being here, Dave. I didn't want to cry. I can't believe I'm sitting here. This is really a big thrill for me. I want to thank all you people. Sent me so many great messages. ESPN, Jimmy Pitaro, all my buddies at ESPN. I want to thank certainly my family and all the fans. My, you've been unbelievable.
And Dickie V was unbelievable on the call. He went through the emotion early.